Oh, man, this is cool. Oh, this is really cool, guys. Well, let's see here. I found it. I found it, guys. Guys, don't ever shine a flashlight in your face. It's not good. Oh, man, that was a close one, guys. We're gonna get ready. Ready here. And, it's been such a fun week. It's been such a fun series doing our Happy Camper series. And, let's see, what did we do first day? It took me forever to find the campsite on the first day. And then the second day we, what was it? Oh yeah. We set up the tent. We had the tent set up. We got the tent all set up and ready to go on our Happy Campers adventure. And it was a really cool tent. I forgot. We unwrapped the sleeping bag and funny story, I got stuck in the sleeping bag, guys. You remember that? Oh, it was so funny. Oh, and then what else did we do? That's right. I went on a hike and I got to see all of God's creation. And then I went on another hike and I found this really cool cabin that I'm sitting at. And then, wait, what else did we do? Do you remember the best part of all? Oh, it was so good and so yummy and so delicious, and it was the best snack ever. Do you know what it is? Can you tell me what it is? That's right, guys, you said it. It was s'mores with the marshmallows and the chocolate. Oh, and the graham crackers. Oh, it was so good, guys. And then what else did we do? Oh, we had our yummy s'mores. And then we saw lions and tigers and bears. Oh, my. Oh, no, wait. That wasn't right. What else did we do? Oh, yeah, I remember. We sang that really cool hip campfire song that I remixed. Whoop, whoop, right? Yep. You remember that remix song. It was pretty cool, huh? And then, what else did we do? Oh, that's right. We told campfire stories, right? We told lots of stories, and it was really cool. And I told you about my story about the fishing pole, right? And we talked about Jesus and how he was alive, and he went to these two men and was walking on the road telling them all about the things that Jesus had said in the Old Testament. And it was really cool, right, guys? And then, what did we do after that? Oh, that's right. I know what we're doing. Talking about a flashlight. Pretty cool, huh? Yep. All right, guys. So we're gonna get ready to enter into some worship. But first I wanna shout out a couple of kids while we're doing our quick little countdown. And so today I'm gonna shout out a couple of kids that I'm excited about. And I just wanna shout out the Vanettes. Okay, you got lots of kids. I wanna shout all of you out, okay? And so I'm shouting out the whole Vanette family. All right, guys, thank you for tuning in on this awesome Sunday. All right, guys, we're gonna get ready to have some worship. See you in just a minute, okay, guys?
greatest day in history. Death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. Empty cross and empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
Tell the world.
Welcome back, guys, from worship. We're sitting around this awesome little campfire here, and we've talked about a lot of camping essentials over the last few weeks, haven't we? We've talked about camping gear, camping activities, camping traditions. We've talked about tents and campfires and sleeping bags. There's one more piece of camping gear I'd like to share with you all. It's the tool that you want to have late at night when you need to find a place to use the bathroom. Can anyone guess what that is? That's right. It's the flashlight. Right? You don't want to go camping without a flashlight, do you? Out in the woods, there's no exterior lighting. If you don't bring your own light, you'll stumble around in the dark, and you might run across some lions and tigers and bears. Oh my! Oh, wait. It's not exactly a safe idea to not have the flashlight, right? But if you bring the flashlight with you, the light you need goes with you wherever you go. It lights your path on the ground, right? It lights your path. It can give you some comfort too, especially when you hear some spooky sounds. Oh, what was that? Guys, did you hear that? Oh, maybe it was lions and tigers and bears. Oh, oh my. I'm so glad I have my flashlight, man. Whew. Jesus wants us to take the light with us. His Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is God's presence who dwells in our hearts. He lives in our hearts. When we have the Holy Spirit, the fire, right? The fire, just like this campfire, the fire we get from being with Jesus goes with us. That fire is with us at home, at school, the grocery store, the park, any place that we go. He keeps us connected to Jesus, and He lights our way in the darkness. If you don't have the Holy Spirit, today is a great day to receive Him. Ask Jesus to be your Savior, and the Holy Spirit will come. He will never leave you, and He will always go with you wherever you go. And that's one life essential you don't want to be without. Well, guys, our camp time has just about come to an end. It's always sad when vacations end, isn't it? Right? We have to leave a place filled with fun memories and return home to normal life. No more hikes, no more songs around the campfires, no more canoes or swimming in the lake or fishing, right? It's time to go back home, back to reality. And of course, you know what that means. We have to figure out what we're going to do when we go and figure out school, right? Because that's coming up too. But one of the most important things to do before you return to reality is to make sure that the campfire is out. Whether you only burn one at night or keep it burning all day, campfires require special attention. One spark in a stray wind can devastate entire forests. That's why we have so many rules and restrictions on campfires. And it's why it's so important that we make sure that they are out before we leave. It's a shame that we can't take the campfire with us, isn't it? The smell of the campfire would bring back so many memories. Every day, as we go about our normal life, we'd remember the place that we've been, and we'd find joy even on the worst of days if we could just get on with a whiff of that fire, right? That smell, that aroma of that fire. There is, however, a fire that we can take with us. This isn't a campfire, but a spiritual fire. It's the fire that burns in our hearts when we meet Jesus in church, when we meet Jesus at VBS, which, by the way, VBS is coming up. So we can have that fire at VBS this year. And it will be totally awesome, guys, because VBS is going to be totally cool this year. We're kicking it old school. And talk to your parents about VBS because it's really cool. But getting back to that spiritual fire that we can have at VBS, right, or at church, okay, or even at camp when we go camping, it's the fire of God's Holy Spirit. But unlike the campfire, this is one fire that we can take with us. In fact, Jesus wants us to take the fire with us to help us remember all that He has done for us and to share that good news with other people. Just like the song we sang today, it was "Tell the World That Jesus Lives," right? So we're going to go back to the book of Acts, to the start of Christ's church, and see how the Holy Spirit came to earth and to those early Christians. So here it goes. We're going to go into Acts 2, 1 to 12. Okay, let me pull that up a minute. We need Acts. 2, 1 to 12. All right. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly a noise came from heaven. It sounded like a strong wind blowing. The noise filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw something that looked like flames of fire, just like this fire that's kind of going out. They were filled with the Holy Spirit, and they began to speak different languages. The Holy Spirit was giving them the power to speak these languages. There were some religious Jews staying in Jerusalem who were from every country in the world. When they heard this noise, a crowd came together. They were all surprised because each one of them heard them speaking in his own language. They were completely amazed at this. They said, "Look, aren't all these men that we hear speaking from Galilee? But each of us hears them in his own language. How is this possible? We are from different places. Parthia, Media, Elam, Mesopotamia, Judea." They go through a whole bunch of other names. And both the Jews and those who had become Jews But we hear these men telling our own languages about the great things God has done. They were all amazed and they were confused. They asked each other, "What does this mean?" So we're going to get back into our lesson. So we're talking about Acts, right? And the fire of the Holy Spirit came upon them and they were speaking in different languages. So Jesus wanted a relationship with all of us, every one of us, but he could not do that in his earthly form. There was only one Jesus, the man, the Son of God, and that person could only be at one place in one time. When Jesus returned to God the Father, he sent God the Holy Spirit to the earth. The Spirit landed on each of the disciples in the upper room. He filled them with God's presence. He gave them the power to speak the gospel in many languages. He gave them the courage to spread the gospel in spite of precaution. That same fire, that same Holy Spirit fire, comes to us when we accept Jesus as our Savior. When you invite Jesus into your heart, it's the Holy Spirit that comes inside. The Holy Spirit connects us to Jesus. He allows us to pray directly to the Lord. He fills us with power to do the work of the Lord. And he lights our path so we can follow God's will. The Holy Spirit is a fire that can go with you wherever you go. If you read on through the book of Acts, you'll see that the Holy Spirit is in action as early church begins to spread. People of all races come to know Jesus, and when they do, they receive the Holy Spirit. Men like Peter are able to do miracles thanks to the Holy Spirit, like casting out demons and healing the sick. And when persecution comes to the church, the Holy Spirit not only comforts the believers, sometimes he even saves them. If you have accepted Jesus as your Savior, the Holy Spirit is already dwelling in your heart and in you. The same Spirit that helped the early church grow goes on with you wherever you go. The more that you pray and spend time with God at home and in God's Word, the more you will feel his presence in your life, kids. The Holy Spirit will guide you. He will protect you and he will comfort you. He will be a constant reminder of the love and goodness of the Lord. If you have never received that Spirit, today, right now, is a great day to do so. Ask Jesus to forgive your sins and send his Holy Spirit to live with you. That, my friends, that is the first step on a new hike, a new journey that will last the rest of your life. It is a journey that you will never regret. I don't know where you are in your life today, kids. Maybe everything is great for you. Maybe life feels just impossibly hard. I want you to know that Jesus knows how you feel. Getting a little emotional, but he wants you to be there in the good times and the bad. He wants to go with you, and he wants you to get to know him. If you just accept him into your life, don't leave this place, don't leave this service without that fire. do it, guys. Don't do it. Don't leave this place without that fire. Accept Jesus today. Invite the Holy Spirit inside. Let the Spirit give you comfort and warmth. And let it be a light to your path, whatever journey you take in this world. And so, if that's you and you want to accept Jesus into your life, I ask you to do it. So when I get ready to close in prayer, I want you to say to yourself while I'm praying, "Dear Jesus, come into my life. Be with me. Be the fire that I need." So with all heads, eyes, and bows, heads bowed and eyes closed, we're going to get ready to pray. Dear God, thank you for sending your Holy Spirit so that we can have a personal relationship with you. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, guys, that was an awesome service. I'm so glad that you tuned in on this awesome Happy Camper Sunday. So sad that we're going to be done with this curriculum. It's so fun, and I loved camping with you guys. I'm going to miss it, and we're going to have to figure out something else fun to do. So, have a good day, guys. Bye!